Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to our celebration of the Holy Mass. Today is our 6th Misa de Gallo, and our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluwag.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Mga kapamilya, ngayon po ay muli kaming bumabati ng magandang umaga sa ating pang-anim na simbang gabi. At patuloy natin alalahanin ang ating mga intensyon para sa nobinang ito. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. Merciful Lord, hear the prayers of your people who celebrate the coming of your Son in human flesh, that when he comes again in glory, we may gain the prize of eternal life. We ask this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. The Song of Songs reflects God's love for his people, Israel. Here, the young woman, who symbolizes the people, is delighted when the bridegroom, who is the Lord, comes to visit her.
A reading from the Song of Songs. Hark, my lover, here he comes springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle or a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattices. My lover speaks. He says to me, "Arise, my beloved, my dove, my beautiful one, and come. For see, the winter is past, the rains are over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, the time of pruning the vines has come, and the song of the dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its fig, and the vines in bloom give forth fragrance. Arise, my beloved, my beautiful one, and come. O my dove, in the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you, let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet, and you are lovely." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, you holy ones, sing a new song to Him.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, you holy ones, sing a new song to Him.
Give thanks to the Lord on the harp, with a 10-stringed lyre chant His praises, sing to Him a new song, pluck the strings skillfully with shouts of gladness.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, you holy ones, sing a new song to Him.
But the plan of the Lord stands forever, the design of His heart through all generations. Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people He has chosen for His own inheritance.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, you holy ones, sing a new song to Him.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield, for in Him our hearts rejoice, in His holy name we trust.
Cry out with joy to the Lord, you holy ones, sing a new song to Him. Alleluia, Alleluia. O Emmanuel, our King and Giver of Law, come to save us, Lord our God. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out in those days and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Kung inyong mapapansin yung ating ebanghelyo ngayong araw ay yung tinatawag na the visitation, di ba? Yung sa misteryo ng mga rosaryo, ito yung visitation, no? And very interesting kasi kahapon pinag-usapan sa ebanghelyo yung annunciation. So makita ninyo, lumalabas naman ngayon yung dalawang nanay, no? Ang mahal na Birhen at si Elizabeth. Noong mga nakarang araw, si San Jose at si Zechariah, yung mga tatay. So ngayon naman yung mga, kumbaga, etern naman ng mga nanay ngayon, no? And I think it's very important to also reflect on the role of Mary and Elizabeth in terms of the mission of their sons, no? John the Baptist for Elizabeth and then Mary for our Lord Jesus Christ, no? I think the two played, you know, very, 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 very crucial roles in the mission of their children. Of course, even Joseph and Zechariah, as we saw in the story of Zechariah, as we will see in the coming part wherein Zechariah again will come to talk about the mission of John the Baptist. No? But let me just first reflect on how, in a sense, the mission of Mary, her yes, as we said yesterday, her yes to God's mission for her brought about Christ into the world. And I think maganda yung pagnilaya natin kasi isa itong pagpapakita at gayon din sa kwento ni Elizabeth na tuwing tayo ay oo sa hinihingi ng Diyos sa atin, sa pinagagawa ng Diyos sa atin, dumadating ang pumapasok ang Diyos sa mundo natin. So for every yes to God's will and to what God wants us to do, we bring God into the world every time we say yes. And that is very clearly seen in the case of our Blessed Mother, in the case of Elizabeth. No? And of course, what they bring into the world is the light of hope, the light of faith. No? Remember, in the Gospels, Christ would talk about John as the light, no? And then Christ would say, no, but I am the light that comes from the Father. I am the light of the world. So it is that mission of how, when every time we say yes to what God wants us to do, we bring light into this world, we bring hope into this world, and we bring God Himself into this world. We become a channel of God's presence in the world. The second interesting thing about Elizabeth and Mary is that in this particular gospel passage, it is such a joyful reunion. Masayang-masaya sila, no? Kung titingnan mo yung ebanghelyo, kung saan nagkita si Elizabeth at si Mary, no? It's very interesting kasi noong, kung matatandaan niyo kahapon sa Annunciation, sinabi ng anghel kay Maria na bilang pagpapatunay, yung pinsan, si Elizabeth, ay nagdadalang tao. No? And note, imagine when the Blessed Mother found out about that, immediately she goes to Elizabeth to take care of her, to care for her during her months of pregnancy. But the meeting of the two, yung pagtatagpo nila ay punong-puno ng galak, di ba? In fact, Elizabeth shows her joy because of remember what she says, the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And Elizabeth knew, and how, what do I deserve? And hindi ako karapat dapat kung bakit dinalaw ako ng ina ng tagapagligtas. And you see that joy because of them being in the presence of Jesus, being in the presence of the Savior. And I think that is the nature also of our mission, no? Of our hope. That our mission and our hope is always filled with joy and gratitude. Gratitude for God's graciousness. Gratitude for God using us as His instruments. Bahagi yan ng pamumuhay ng isang Kristiyano na tapat na sumusunod sa kagustuhan ng Diyos. Hindi lamang tayo pinagmumulan ng pag-asa, kundi kasama o kaakibat ng pag-asang yon ay ang kagalakan. I think in the end, hope and joy are twin graces. A hope and joy that comes from a deep sense of gratitude because God deemed it worthy to make us His instruments, to give us a mission for our world to become better. So that's second point. And then the third point, no, I don't want to be a spoiler, but ito rin yung makikita natin sa kwento ng Mahal na Birhen at ni Elizabeth. Na dito makikita mo ang kanilang kagalakan. Pero alam natin na yung misyon ng kanilang mga anak ay mamatay para sa ating kaligtasan. And yet, I think it also reminds us of what the Lord will say later on, that you will share in my joy, in a joy that no one can take. And I think mahalaga yan na ating pagnilayan din, dahil nga sa dinaanan natin itong siyam na buwan na ito, ay yung bahagi ng ating kagalakan ay bahagi din dyan ng mga ating mga sakripisyo. Na kung minsan hindi natin mapaghihiwalay. Kagaya nga rin ng kasabihan, di ba, that pain and love come together. I think joy and sorrow from the Christian perspective also come together. But I think our joy is deeper na hindi nawawala ang ating kagalakan dahil sa ating mga sakripisyo. In fact, our joy becomes deeper and more meaningful precisely because of the sacrifices that we make. Our Blessed Mother will lose her son, will carry the dead body of her son. Elizabeth's son, John the Baptist, will be beheaded and die a martyr's death. And yet, this does not take away the joy. And I think in the end, our Christian joy really overcomes all sacrifices. It gives us that perspective that the final word of our faith is joy. So today, let us pray for that. Let us pray that we may again continue to deepen our journey of understanding our mission and also of deepening the faith that we can bring into the world like Mary and Elizabeth. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us glorify the Father who chose the Virgin Mary to be the mother of his Son. Let us ask him,
Lord, hear your people.
Through Mary's intercession, grant peace to our land, wisdom and strength to our church and civil leaders, and confidence and unity to our people, we pray.
Lord, hear your people.
May parents foster love and holiness in their homes. May children contribute to the building up of the family. And may the elderly be seen as guardians of the collective memory of the family and offer young people precious advice and guidance, we pray.
Lord, hear your people.
May our homes be havens of love and places of welcome for those who come in need, we pray.
Lord, hear your people.
May Filipino families living overseas serve as examples to other families in becoming a genuine domestic church by humbly and lovingly living out the Christian vocation, we pray.
Lord, hear your people.
May those who have gone ahead of us find peace and eternal happiness, sharing in the joy of the Master's table, we pray.
Lord, hear your people.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, hear your people.
Lord, hear the prayers of your people. May we who celebrate with joy the birth of your Son as man, rejoice in the gift of eternal life when he comes again in glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, accept from your church these gifts, which in your mercy you have given to us to offer, and by your power you transform into the sacrament of our salvation. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them, and grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
And let us pray. Lord, may the divine mysteries we have shared keep your people safe from harm, so that ever faithful to your service, we may enjoy salvation of mind and body. Grant this in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May your family always rejoice together, O God, over the mysteries of redemption they have celebrated, and grant its members the perseverance to attain the effects that flow from them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.